Hello friends, in this tutorial let's learn stand editor method. This is the example of the stand editor method we are going to do. This is a planar frame structure having two columns, one beam. Each member 3 meters length. 1, 2, 3 are the members, 1, 2, 3, 4 are the nodes. Red color I have written 1, 2, 3, 4 in red color, that is nodes. 1, 2, 3 in blue color are the beams. First node is located at origin 0, 0, 0. Second node 0, 3, 0. Third node 3, 3, 0. Fourth node 3, 0, 0. In editor method, we have to mention each node is located at what distance from origin. And coming to the size of the members, let beams and columns be 0.3, 0.23. 0.3 is depth, 0.23 is width. Otherwise, depth be 0.4 and width 0.23. The minimum size of any member, that is beam or column, should be 9 inches by 9 inches, that is 230 by 230 mm or 0.23 by 0.23. Properties are always assumed initially. The minimum size we can assume is 0.23 by 0.23, 9 inches by 9 inches. After design, if we don't get reinforcement, then we have to change the member sizes. Let's open the software. First, we have to set the units. Click configuration button, base units, metric, accept. Then go to new project, choose plane option. Here we have options like space, plane, floor, truss. If you are drawing truss, choose truss. If you are drawing floor, choose floor. If you are drawing structure, space structure, choose space. So this is a planar structure, so choose plane, give the name planar frame structure and the location where you want to save the file, and units are already set. So you have to create one folder and you have to save file in that folder. Go to next button, already same name is there, it's not asked to replace, say yes and choose open stand editor, click finish. Now editor page came, control A, select all, delete, empty the editor page. Now let's type one by one all the information about the structure. First line is stand plane, means in stand we are drawing planar structure. Second line, units, space meter, space, KNS, length units meters, force units kilonewtons. In third line, joint coordinates and where joints are located, 1, 0, 0, 0. First joint is at origin 0, 0, 0. In second line type 2 space 0 space 3 space 0. Second joint is at 0, 3, 0. And similarly third joint is at 3, 3, 0. Fourth joint is at 3, 0, 0. Where joints are located, that information we have to input. Suppose if we enter only this much information and close, we will see only that much structure. Wait a minute. Let's close the editor page. Yes. We should see four nodes. If you don't see, use the shortcut key Shift K. If you use Shift K, then nodes are visible. So only Shift N, node numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4 are the node numbers. So if you see the structure, 1, 2, 3, 4 are node numbers. We have typed all the joint coordinates values 0, 0, 0, 3, 0, 0, 3, 3, 0, 3, 0, 0. See, let's continue giving more information. Go to Style Editor page, click Style Editor button in File toolbar. And the next line, type member instances, means where members are located. 1, 2, 3 are the members. Then we have to type like this: 1 space 2. Member 1 is between 1 and 2 joints. 2 space 3. Member 2 is between 2 and 3 joints. 3 space 4. Member 3 is between 3 and 4 joints. Close the editor page. Yes. Now we see the members. 1, 2, 3 are the members. Shift B to display beam numbers. 1, 2, 3. Shift B. Right click 3D rendering. When 3D rendering, if you see, this is the only length we can see. So each member, beam or column, will have length, width, 3 dimension, length, width, depth. So right now we are seeing only length because we have input only geometry information. Go to editor page, continue inputting the information. Let's type member properties. The next line, 1 space, 2 space, 3 space, prismatic space, YD space, 0.4 space, ZD space, 0.23 means 1, 2, 3 are the members. Prismatic means concrete structure. YD measurement, ZD measurement, width and depth for the members. After giving, you can see rendered view. We can see 3 dimensions and render view only. Or in view toolbar, click 3D render. Then we can see. Let's go to editor page, continue typing the more information. In the next line, let's type constants. E concrete all means consider elastic modulus for all concrete members. Poisson concrete all means consider Poisson's ratio for all concrete members. The next line, type supports, enter. Next line, 1 fixed, 1 space, 4 space fixed means 1 and 4 joints having fixed support. If you close the editor page, yes, we can see the supports are joint 1 and joint 4. Support information is given. So joint 1, joint 4 having fixed supports. Let's go to the editor page, give the load information. In the next line, type load 1. Enter. Member load. Load 1 means first load. Member load means we are applying load on beam. It is called member load. And the next line, 2 space UNI space GY space minus 2 means member 2. On member 2, we are applying UNI, uniform distributed load, in global Y direction. Minus 2 means opposite to Y axis direction. That's why minus 2. We are applying 2 kN load. If you want to see the load diagram on the beam, click loads icon in the structure toolbar. When you click loads icon, we can see the loads diagram. Shift V will display the load value. Double click beam or column, we can see 3 tabs: geometry, property, loading. This is the input we have given to the structure. Beside loading, we should see deflection and shear bending tabs. We can see after analysis. Let's go to editor page. In the next line, type perform analysis. Next line, print analysis results and finish. Blue color are the numbers, red color are the names. Between every number, between every word, we should give space. Let's double click now. Still we don't see deflection shear bending tabs. Main menu, go to analyze, run analysis. Then analysis is taking place. Click done. Now double click beam or column, we will see the tab shear bending and deflection tabs. So in this we have information about the displacements, shear forces and bending moments. Next click post processing button, we see the same information in the table. Click post processing. So when we double click the beam, when we click deflection, we are seeing displacement value is 0 because x direction is on. Means in x direction we don't have any deflections. On y direction we can see deflection diagram and values. If you click z direction, and we don't see any deflection diagram and values are 0. Means beam is not deflecting in x and z, only deflecting in y direction. When you click shear bending tab, you can see bending moment and shear force diagrams. and F5 means shear force, M7 means bending moment. You can double click B more column and you can see all that information. Next, click post processing. Okay, we see the same information in the table. The green color line is the deflection diagram. 1, 2, 3.